You laughed and laughed and laughed by Gabriel O'Hara. You laughed and laughed and laughed is a beautiful poem penned by Gabriel O'Hara. This poem mainly depicts the life of African people who faced racism by whites. Let's get familiarized with the poet. Gabriel Imomotimi O'Hara was a Nigerian poet and novelist. He was born on 24th April 1921 in Niger Delta, Nigeria. He was the first modernist poet of Anglophone Africa. His modernist works changed African poetry. He was best known for his early experimental novel, The Voice, which was published in 1964. Gabriel's most famous poems are Piano and Drums and You Laughed and Laughed and Laughed, which is a frequent feature of anthologies. In both his poems and his prose, O'Hara drew on African thought, religion, folklore and imagery, and he has been called as the Nigerian Negrijudist. According to Brenda Marie Osbay, who was the editor of Gabriel's collected poems, it is with the publication of O'Hara's first poem that Nigerian literature in English and modern African poetry in this language can be said truly to have begun. After his first poem, that is, The Call of the River Nun, he won an award at Nigerian Festival of Arts in the year 1953. Several of his poems were featured in Nigerian literary journal, namely Black Orpheus. Gabriel O'Hara died on 25th March 2019 in Federal Medical Center, Yenagoa, Nigeria. As I said earlier, this particular poem depicts the life of African people who faced racism by whites. They were laughed by the whites for their songs, their dance and their music, which brought out their inner feelings of black natives, also brought out their emotions. Also, this poem brings out an emotion, feeling, pain and sufferings faced by the Africans. The whites don't even understand the pain suffered by them. This poem is written like a discussion or an interaction that takes place between a white colonist and a black native. There is a particular reason for the title. You laughed and laughed and laughed. The poet titled this song with such a title because the blacks were laughed and mocked by the whites. They were even laughed for their songs, their dance, their music, and they were even discriminated for their color. Throughout the poem, the poet portrays the domination of whites. As an African poet, he brought such a concept. Now, let's get into the chapter. In your ears, my song is motor car misfiring, stopping with a chalking cuff. And you laughed and laughed and laughed. So here the poet says that the whites laughed at the blacks for whatever they do. When they sing a song out of pain, their emotion is not understood by the whites. Instead of listening to their song or instead of understanding the meaning of that particular song, what they do is mocking. According to the whites, the African song sounds them as misfiring of car. So here misfiring means failing to start or failing to produce the result. In case of car, it usually happens when the car has certain engine problems. So we know if a car has certain engine problems, it usually start with an awkward noise, which is similar to the sound of a cuff. So here the word chucking means carelessly. So if a car has certain engine problems, it usually produces an awkward noise and it instantly stops. So, when African people sing a song, whites consider that song as the misfiring of a car. These songs were a part of Africans' culture, but the whites consider no value for it. Instead of praising them, they laughed and laughed and laughed at them. So, the whites' attitude towards African song is being portrayed here. In your eyes, my antenatal walk was inhuman, passing your omnivorous understanding, and you laughed and laughed and laughed. The Africans were not stylish as the whites. They were even mocked for their walk. Africans were considered as inhuman, which means without any human feelings. So the whites even mocked the Africans for their walking. This is mentioned within the phrase antenatal walk, which simply means that they are even mocked for their walk. Here the word omnivorous understanding means they understand everything that happens around. The whites understands the Africans as people without any feelings, without any human feelings. That is, the whites consider Africans as people with no human feelings. That's why the Africans are being mocked by the whites. You laughed at my song. You laughed at my walk. So we already had discussed whites' attitude towards Africans' song and their walk. So that idea is being portrayed in these two lines. The poet summarizes the above two paragraphs within these two lines. Then I danced my magic dance to the rhythm of talking drums pleading, but you shut your eyes and laughed and laughed and laughed. So here, the whites' attitude towards African dance is being portrayed. The poet says that their dance, the African dance, seems something magical. They dance according to their culture. They danced according to the music, to the rhythm of talking drums. The Africans even longed for a look, or they even pleaded for a look. Actually, the Africans want the whites to even look at their dance. But instead of looking at their dance or instead of praising them, they shut their eyes. So the Africans want a look. They want a look at their dance, but instead of looking at their dance, the whites closed their eyes. And they even mocked at them. That is, you laughed and laughed and laughed. So they are being mocked for their song, for their walk, and even for their dance. And then I opened my mystic inside, wide like the sea. Instead, you entered your car and laughed and laughed and laughed. Here the word mystic means wide space. It simply symbolizes the wonder or the beauty of Africa. So the beauty of African space is being portrayed in this small line. So as wide like a sky, the African space is also wide and very much beautiful. But instead of enjoying the beauty of that place, what the whites did was that they left the place in car. Without even having a look at the place or without even enjoying or praising the place, the white left the place. And they laughed and laughed and laughed. That is, they mocked at them. So instead of praising them, what they did was mocking. You laughed at my dance. You laughed at my inside. You laughed and laughed and laughed. So here the poet says that the whites kept on mocking at the Africans. They mocked or they laughed at everything what the Africans did. They laughed at their song. They laughed at their walk. They laughed at their dance. The whites laughed at everything in Africans. They kept on mocking or they kept on laughing. But your laughter was ice block. Laughter and it will froze your inside, froze your voice, froze your ears, froze your eyes and froze your tongue. Here the poet says that as a result of this mocking, the whites had lost their warmth. Due to their continuous mocking or continuous laughing, the whites had lost their warmth inside. They become cold as ice block. So as they kept on mocking at the Africans, the whites had lost their warmth inside and they become as cold as an ice block. Their voice, their ears, their eyes, their tongue, their heart, etc. Everything in them has frozen. So as a result of continuous mocking, the whites had lost the warmth in them and everything inside them has frozen. Mocking made them cold as ice block. And now it's my turn to laugh, but my laughter is not ice block laughter, for I know not cars,
no, not ice blocks.
So here the poet has made a small comparison between the attitude of whites towards the Africans and the attitude of Africans towards the whites. The whites usually mock at everything the Africans do. And the poet says that the Africans are not like the whites. The poet says that Africans are not materialistic, so they have a friendly heart. As they have a friendly heart, they have warmth in their heart. So, due to a friendly heart, they have warmth in them, which prevents them from getting cold or getting frozen, just like the whites. So, unlike the whites, the Africans had a friendly heart. So, they have warmth in them, which prevents them from getting frozen. So, they won't laugh at the hardships faced by the whites. My laughter is the fire of the eye of sky, the fire of earth, the fire of air, the fire of the seas and the rivers, fishes, animals, trees. And it thawed your inside, thawed your voice, thawed your ears, thawed your eyes and thawed your tongue. So here the poet describes the African's laughter as the fire of a sun. Here sun is described as the eye of sky. So the poet says that the African's laughter is like the fire of the sun, like the hot fire of the sun. The intensity of sun's hot fire is being portrayed here. There is nothing more hotter than sun. Their laughter is like the fire of earth, which is one of the five elements of earth. So here the poet says that their laughter is like the fire of earth, and their laughter is like the fire of air, that is the lightning. And their laughter is like a fire in everything around them. That is the fire in seas, the rivers, in fishes, animals, trees, etc. So, their laughter is like the fire in everything around them. Here the word thawed means softens. So, the intensity of their fire can soften the frozen hearts of the whites. Simply, the African's laughter is fit enough to melt the ice over the whites. So, as we discussed earlier, due to continuous smoking, the whites had frozen everything inside them. Their eyes, ears, tongue, heart, everything. So, the poet says that the African's laughter is fit enough to melt the ice over the whites. So, the intensity of African's laughter is being described through the fire of everything. In the fire of sun, air, seas, earth, animals, trees, fishes, etc. So that fire, that intensity of fire is able to melt the ice over the whites. So a meek wonder held, you shadow and you whispered, why so? And I answered, because my fathers and I are owned by the living warmth of the earth through our naked feet. So this is the concluding stanza of this poem. So the poet says that the African's laughter can melt the ice over the whites. By doing so, the whites may wonder at their attitude. The whites might wonder about the attitude of the Africans. Though they are humiliated or mocked by the whites, they help them in melting the ice over them. Instead of taking a revenge, the Africans had helped the whites. So by seeing this, the whites may wonder. And they even ask a question, why so? After all this humiliation, why these Africans are behaving like this? So such a question might appear in every white's mind. So the poet, he himself is giving the answer to such a question. The poet gives the answer as they and their ancestors were made up by the warmth of the earth. They all are nourished by the earth's warmth. The warmth in every African's heart is given by the earth. Or the friendly attitude, the warmly attitude is given by the earth. The Africans consider themselves as a part of nature. The poet concludes by stating that they absorb all these qualities from the earth through their naked feet. So standing on the earth with our naked feet is considered as a close communication with the earth. It is a close communication with the earth. So the poet claims that the Africans had got or absorbed all these warm quality or friendly qualities from the earth through their naked feet. So let's just summarize the concluding part. So here the poet says that the intensity of the laughter or the laughter of the Africans is fit enough to melt the ice over the whites, which they got as a result of continuous smoking. So instead of taking a revenge, the Africans had helped the whites in removing the coal from them. So by seeing this, or by seeing the Africans' attitude, the whites might wonder how could the blacks behave so warmly or friendly after all these sufferings or all these humiliations. And the poet says that the whites may search for the answer, and the poet himself come in front to provide the answer. He says that he and his ancestors were born and made up by the earth, by the warmth of the earth. They got this warmth in their heart from the earth itself. The earth has provided them with this warmth, and the Africans had absorbed all this warmth from earth through their naked feet, which is considered as a close communication with the earth. In short, it is a warning. So the poet concludes the poem with a warning. Throughout the poem, the line, "You laughed and laughed and laughed," is being repeated. Here the word "laughed" denotes the whites, who dominated the natives for their abnormal actions. Also, it depicts the idea that the whites always mocked at everything the Africans do. So that's all about the poem. I hope this video would be helpful for you. Thank you.